Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
So today we are here to study about our chapter in nutrition in plants. So can you tell me what is nutrition? A proper definition of nutrition. What is nutrition? Anyone? Yes. Okay, very good. Sure. Nutrition is the process of taking in of food and its utilization by the body. That means we have to first take in the food and utilize it. For what? To get energy. So we utilize it. That whole process is known as nutrition. Here it is that the process of taking in of food by the body and its utilization by the body is nutrition. Now, what we get after nutrition? Energy. But only nutrition process do not give us energy. It also include respiration. So nutrition and respiration, both process combinedly give us energy to do work, any work that we have to do. So what are the two types of nutrition? Autotrophic nutrition. So we have divided the nutrition in two parts, autotrophic nutrition and hypertrophic nutrition. Autotrophic nutrition and hypertrophic nutrition. Hypertrophic nutrition then divided into further parasites, partial parasites, insectivorous and
saprophytes.
Okay, so first we can study about autotrophic nutrition. But is autotrophic nutrition? Auto means
self.
Tropism means
free.
In that, in this process, autotrophic nutrition, in this nutrition, the organism makes its own food by simple inorganic substances like carbon dioxide and water. What the plant do? They use inorganic simple substances, carbon dioxide and water, and make their food. So this is autotrophic nutrition. Like simple substances, we can see in the picture that this there is a plant. It take water from the root, it absorb carbon dioxide from the atmosphere, it contain the leaves, colors are green, because it contains
chlorophyll.
So chlorophyll trap the energy from sunlight. What it do? Trap the energy from
sunlight.
And from that energy, it make food from carbon dioxide and
water.
And it produce glucose. What it produce?
Glucose.
With a byproduct of oxygen. Plant do not need that oxygen, so it releases the oxygen into the atmosphere and store or use the glucose. What is the formula of glucose?
C6H12O6.
So it stores the glucose in many parts like roots, stems, flowers, fruits, mainly fruits and vegetables are the stored food. But they are stored food. So only leaves can do photosynthesis? No. Any part which is green in color. Any part of the plant which is green in color. So it contains chlorophyll. It contains
chlorophyll.
So it can, what can it can do? It can photosynthesize. Or it can make food. Okay, now the second point is heterotrophic nutrition. What is heterotrophic nutrition? In this, organism get food from some other organism. It depends on some other organism for their food, like all the animals and non-green plants. All the animals and non-green plants. Okay, one more question. All the green plants are autotrophic, autotrophs?
No.
No. All the green plants are not autotrophs. Some may be heterotrophs. We will discuss in further. So here we can see that this plant make food from sunlight, and it what it can do?
It can
herbivorous or herbivorous eaten by carnivorous or omnivorous eat both. And what the food transform from one point to now the types of heterotrophic nutrition. First one is saprotrophs. In saprotrophs, What we have? In this method, the organism gets that food from dead or decaying matter. That is the other part of the plant. Dead or decaying matter, that is organic matter. It means the dead or decaying part of some organism, plant or animal. We can see in the picture. These are saprotrophs. What they are? What they do? They secrete the digestive juice on the tree trunk. On this tree trunk and absorb nutrition from the trunk. So it taking food from another organism. So it is saprotroph. It means it is a heterotrophic nutrition. What it is? Now next is symbiosis. In symbiosis, two different organisms work together for their mutual benefit. For what? Their mutual benefit. Okay. So, with example, we can see that the fungus and algae. In the picture, we can see that fungus and algae, they work together. Fungus provides nutrients and minerals to the algae. Algae prepares food and it provides back food to the fungus. So they work mutually. They both get benefited. So this is known as symbiosis. What is it known as?
Symbiosis
is different from parasites. As in parasites, the organism live on another organism that is host without its permission. Okay, but in symbiosis, they live together for their mutual benefit. Clear? So in parasites, some plants that are also parasites, what they do? They take food from another plant. What they do? They take food from another plant. They are also heterotrophs. There are some parasites. What they do? They do not take the food. They do take nutrients from other plant. What they do? And they prepare their food from that nutrients. They took nutrients from other plant and prepare their own food. So they are green in color, but they are heterotrophic in nutrition because they are taking nutrients from some other organism. So they are heterotrophic in nutrition. Now the next is plants taking nutrients from soil. So the level of nutrition in the soil gets exhausted or reduced. So soil becomes infertile. But that is not at all. That the nutrition is taken by the plants get back to the soil. How? The dead or dead part of the plants or animal, dead bodies or dead part of the plant or animal, they get decomposed. What they get?
Decomposed.
And mixed in the soil. So the nutrition taken by the plants get replaced to the soil by that this process decomposition. So what we are studying? We are studying green plants use water, carbon dioxide, sunlight to prepare their food by the process photosynthesis. Energy of the photosynthesis obtained from sunlight that is trapped by the
chlorophyll.
All non-green plants and animals are heterotrophs. Non-green plants that is parasites, saprotrophs and insectivorous. Okay, one more thing. Insectivorous plants like pitcher plant or Venus flytrap. What they do? They are green in color and they can synthesize their own food. Photosynthesis process takes place inside them. But they are heterotrophs. Why? Because they get some nutrients or minerals from some other insects. What they do? They trap insects and consume them. Take nutrients and minerals from them. So they are depending on some other organism. They are making their own food, but they are depending on some other organism also. So they are heterotrophic in nature. Okay, there are some questions like we make our own food in the kitchen. We make our own food in the kitchen. So we are autotrophs?
No.
Because we are making food from organic substances. What we are doing? Making food from organic substances. Okay, now next one. Animals, why animals can't make food from carbon dioxide, water and sunlight?
Because they don't have
suppose we do not contain chlorophyll, we do not have chlorophyll. So we do not trap the energy from the sunlight and can't convert carbonation water into glucose. Now next question that we have discussed, that teacher plant and Venus flytrap are green plant. They synthesize their food, but they are depend on insects. Why? To get some minerals or other nutrients. The last one is plants do not have digestive system. Why?
Because their food is simple in nature.
Because the food prepared in them, that is glucose, is the simplest form. So they do not need to break down in the some other part. So they do not need digestive system. Okay, I hope you understand it. Thank you.